Hi everyone, this is Poppet. I'm gonna show you how I do a quick brush on my dog. The plan is four steps. I'm gonna dampen with just water. You can use a little bit of conditioner in your water if you like. I typically will use Magic Touch, dilute it as per instructions, end up with something like this. But today I'm just gonna use water. Then I'm gonna run it through with the pin brush. Now these come in different sizes. Sometimes I use one that has longer tines on it. Sometimes I use the shorter one like this one. Then I'm gonna slicker brush. Now slicker brushes come in a few styles. Here's a typical slicker brush. Conceptually, the same kind of a tool. This is a La Pooch product, which I really like. It outperforms these brushes and the other similar pet store bought brushes, but it's all the same kind of separation of hair, same kind of tooth design. These ones are a little bit longer. I don't know if you can see that or not, but they're a little bit longer and still got some hair in it. And in this product, I also buy the smaller one. So I like both La Pooch's product. And the last thing I'm gonna do after that is I'm gonna run the comb through. So here's the concept. I first will prepare my dog. You'll notice that she's laying over on her side. And you know what? This is really important. If I'm gonna help my dog be groomed her whole life, even when she's old, it's gonna take time. And this process, she's already been up on this table now half an hour because I did the toe videos first. And look at her, she's a little bit warm, I think, because it's warm over here. But this is easy on her, and she can easily tolerate grooming while her body is not under a lot of stress, trying to stand on three legs, stand on a shoulder that might be hurting. So I teach them to lay over, and I call it bang, because that's what the trick looks like, bang, and you fall over. My friend calls it relax. You can call it whatever you like, as long as the puppy is learning to lay over and relax. So here's where I'm going to start. I'm going to start with spraying with my water. Now, why do we do this? This is because hair is more elasticy when it's damp. And if we don't dampen it a bit, it will break rather than stretch. And I don't want to break all her hair. I want to be able to separate it with the next tools coming. So this is why we dampen. So there is a difference. Dampen compared to fresh, wet bath. We don't want to brush a fresh, wet bath dog. I'm saying that those clumps of hair that happen when that dog is freshly wet with a hose or a spray nozzle is too much water, and it clumps the hair together and it hurts, frankly. So in grooming a Sheltie, we're gonna have a bit of time, if this was a freshly bathed dog, to actually dry her without brushing, especially with fine-toothed tools. If I did anything with a sopping wet dog, it would be using my pin brush. Okay, so I put a bit of moisture on her. I'm gonna do a little bit more at her front end, her shoulder, and I'm gonna do a bit of her belly today. So you'll notice I'm not spending a whole lot of attention at her head and big roughened ears, because I'm gonna do that last. I am gonna undress her because she's got her bandana on, and I'm gonna wanna get in here a bit. So let's take off all our collars and stuff, equipments. There we go. Poppet. Let's just put this back here. All right, so I'm gonna line brush. And what does that mean? That means I'm gonna use my tool to help me make some clear lines, parts, so that I can separate the hair. And when I do that, and you'll see in a minute, it'll be more clear, I'll be able to get my tools right to the skin and base of the hair. So here we go. I'm gonna use one hand, it's my left hand, because I'm right-handed, my tool's in my right hand, And I'm going to use my tool, it's a little bit dry back here, to help me separate the hair. So I'm going to pull my hand forward, and I'm brushing away from me for my first bit of this line, and then towards me. Oh, can you see already? Oh, look, my dog needs brushing. So why do we start with this brush instead of going straight to the next size? So now I'm ready to do the next bit. So I'm going to use my tool to grab the next half inch or so of hair. Do you see how I do that? I'm going to pull down the next bunch of hairs to be line brushed. Next bunch of hairs to be line brushed. Brush it away from me. So this tool is going to help remove some of the bigger tangles and debris. Debris are things that your puppy comes in the house with that he finds in the yard. Things like twigs, sticks, and pine needles. All right, so I've done a little bit forward and behind this line. Again, I'm going to use my tool. I'm going to pull up the next. Oh, look, we have dirt. I'm going to pull up the next little bit, and I'm going to move along as I do this. Let me change hands so maybe you can see better. All right, so now I'm using, see, one hand helps keep the hair from pulling through whilst I make sure my tool gets as close to that root as I can. See how that works? So you know what typically happens is we end up, if we don't do this with a plan, we end up with a really nice clean top line, and then all of these parts are tangly and not brushed properly. So here we go. I'm pulling up the next bunch of hair. I'm gonna come back through, getting to the roots as I go. Can you see the difference? Smoother, chunkier, bumpier, not arranged. So this is helping me arrange these furs, get to the root, and have them all ready, have the hairs all ready for the next stage. So here I go, pulling down a new section. Now, see how this works? Okay, I think I'm gonna turn off my video whilst I work away at this so you don't have to be bored out of your mind. And I can come back and I'll show you the next parts as I get to more fun stuff. That's the plan. Oh, my puppet's